from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Myl. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from two donors. The first is an anonymous donor from Wisconsin in thanksgiving for blessings received during difficult times, for family intentions, for the children to grow in faith, and for the deceased members of the family. The second are the Sisters of St. Casimir of Chicago, Illinois, that we may all pray and work for peace and justice in our world and for the beatification of the founder, venerable servant of God, Maria Kopus. Casimira Kopus, later Mother Maria, founded the Sisters of St. Casimir in Scranton, Pennsylvania in 1907 to preserve and nurture the faith life of Lithuanian immigrants in the United States. In 1911, the congregation established its center in Chicago, Illinois. In 1920, Mother Maria returned to her homeland, Lithuania, to establish the congregation there, which continues to this day. She had plans to send sisters to Argentina, which became a reality shortly after her death in 1940. Throughout these 113 years, the Sisters of St. Casimir have lived their mission by engaging in education, healthcare, and other ministries that reflect the spirit and faith-filled vision of their founder, Venerable Mother Maria Kopus. To this day, they continue their mission, particularly addressing the needs of our time through their involvement in prayer and the witness of their lives. Mother Maria's spirit is very much alive in the hearts of the sisters, associates of the congregation, and in the many places and peoples where the sisters have ministered. For 27 years, Mother Maria carried out her responsibilities of leading the Sisters of St. Casimir with great courage, charity, and openness to the needs of the times. She died in a mother house in Chicago, Illinois, on April 17, 1940. She was deeply loved and acclaimed as a holy woman. A newspaper article published about her death acclaimed that Chicago's second Cabrini died. Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord on this Ash Wednesday, we do not have a penitential rite, and we go straight into the collect. Grant, O Lord, that we may begin with holy fasting this campaign of Christian service, so that as we take up battle against spiritual evil, we may be armed with weapons of self-restraint. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Joel. Even now, says the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning. Rend your hearts and not your clothing. Return to the Lord, your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and relents from punishing. Who knows whether the Lord will not turn and relent and leave a blessing behind him, a grain offering and a drink offering, to be presented to the Lord, your God? Blow the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, call a solemn assembly, gather the people, sanctify the congregation, assemble the aged, gather the children, even infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom leave his room and the bride her canopy. Between the vestibule and the altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep. Let them say, spare your people, O Lord, and do not make your heritage a mockery, a byword among the nations. Why would it be said among the peoples, where is their God? Then the Lord became jealous for his land and had pity on his people. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Against you, you alone have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. Have mercy, O Lord, for we have sinned. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, "Be aware of practicing your piety before people in order to be seen by them, for then you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly I tell you, they have received the reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly I tell you, they have received the reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room, shut the door, and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you fast, do not look dismal like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces so as to show others that they are fasting. For truly I tell you, they have received the reward. But when you fast, put on oil on your head, wash your face, so that your fasting may be seen not by others, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As we start Lent season on this day, as Wednesday, and so the first reading, Joel, we don't know really when Joel was written, probably somewhere actually between 1,000 years before Christ and about 400 years before Christ. But what I always find so interesting is really over time, nothing has changed in human nature. And so when we look at the gospel reading of today, Jesus says, don't put on a show. And the same with Joel. Don't put on a show. Don't be a hypocrite. You know, don't do all kinds of outward practices. And so people say, oh, you're so holy. Oh, wow, you only take one meal a day or whatever it is. Because it's about getting attention to oneself. And then, of course, as Jesus says, well, you got your reward already. People gave you your attention. No. It starts in the heart. Go to your room. Repent. And in your room, in your silence, yes, there might be something to work on. It's especially Lent. It's about looking at our inner shadows. Where can I improve? And to find something what will help our spiritual life. And that can be anything. If you ask me to fast a lot, I say, well, no big deal. I'm struggling already to eat. That's why I'm skinny. So I have to find something else. Someone who's smoking might just say to themselves, hey, let's try half the amount of smoke. Or someone who's struggling with an addiction. And we all know how difficult it is. That's why it's a disease. How difficult it is to break an addiction, if it is alcohol, drugs, or whatever. And cold turkey usually doesn't work. We have plenty of stories that it doesn't work. But to say, okay, I'm going to try a little bit less. I'll just give my body just enough that I can bear it. And to do it quietly, not to make a big scene out of it. And that is our spiritual life. But it starts by training ourselves. And this really goes on to our last breath, training ourselves. And of course, initially it can be very hard in our lives, especially when someone has a conversion. But later on, as we get older, it is just the little things, the fine-tuning, this little self-denial. And out of that, the little acts, quietly done in our hearts, the big acts come. And so today, our sponsor, the Sisters of St. Casimir, and their founder, Maria Kopus. She was also someone who trained herself and overcame her big desires, her worldly intentions, by little acts of internal conversion. And as she made that conversion, she actually came to North America and she said, my goodness, what am I doing? But God was with her and she was open to that voice. And so Mary Kopus, she had a saying she used quite a bit. Always more, always better. Always love for God and neighbor. Always love. But it's not about making big shows outside. It's about in our prayer life, letting God convert our heart. Amen. And so let us bring our prayers before the Lord. We pray for all those in the Daily TV Mass community who have asked to be included in a prayer intention book, especially those who are suffering in mind, body, and spirit, that they may find relief and healing through Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that many women and men will hear God's calling to vowed religious life, especially to the Sisters of St. Casimir. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that this Lenten season will be a new start for many, especially those trying to overcome an addiction. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen. And before we go into the Eucharistic prayers, we will bless the ashes. Dear sisters and brothers, Let us humbly ask God, our Father, that he be pleased to bless with the abundance of his grace these ashes, which we will put on our heads in penance. O God, who desire not the death of sinners, but their conversion, mercifully hear our prayers, and in your kindness be pleased to bless these ashes, which we intend to receive upon our heads, that we who acknowledge we are but ashes and shall return to dust, may through steadfast observance of Lent gain pardon for sins and newness of life after the likeness of your risen Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. And so, in these difficult, unpredictable times, I will invite you to a virtual blessing with ashes. And just move your head a little bit closer to the TV, and I give a virtual blessing. Write on your forehead. Remember that you are ashes, and to ashes you will return. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his Church.
As we solemnly offer the annual sacrifice for the beginning of Lent, we entreat you, O Lord, that through works of penance and charity, we may turn away from harmful pleasures and, cleansed from our sins, may become worthy to celebrate devoutly the passion of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels as we, with one voice of praise, we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, the order bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Would those of you at home join with me now in this act of spiritual communion? My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. As though you were already there, I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. May the sacrament we have received sustain us, O Lord, that our Lenten fast may be pleasing to you and be for us a healing remedy through Christ, O Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow your heads for a final blessing. Pour out a spirit of compunction, O God, on those who bow before your majesty, and by your mercy may they merit the rewards you promise to those who do penance, through Christ, O Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.